Let's talk about solving rational expressions. So this is what's called a rational expression or a rational equation. Because it's rational, that's the technical term in math, because there's an x on the bottom of a fraction. That makes it a rational expression, and this makes that a rational equation. When we say solve, we want to know what x equals. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to multiply the entire equation by 2x. That's 2x would be basically the lowest common denominator of this fraction and that fraction. When we multiply the entire equation by 2x, we're going to eliminate these denominators and make it a simple algebra expression, or a simple algebra equation, I mean. So I'm going to do that. The most important step, or the most common careless error people make, is to forget to multiply by this part. You've got to remember to do that. So 2x times 2 over x. The x's are going to cancel. They're going to cross-cancel. This is really 2x over 1. So the x's cross-cancel, leaving me 2 times 2 is 4. 2x and times negative 1 over 2, the 2's are going to cancel, leaving me negative 1x. X times negative 1 is negative 1x. Equals, again, a lot of people just put 3. You've got to remember to multiply. 2x times 3, 6x. And now we've turned this sort of intimidating looking thing, it might not be intimidating, but to some people it is, we've turned this rational equation into a simple algebraic equation. So now we want to get x alone, we want to combine like terms, we're going to add x to both sides. That cancels. 4 equals 6 plus x is 7x. We want to get x alone, divide both sides by 7. Cancels. X alone equals 4/7. That's the solution to this rational equation.